work systemically and psychotherapeutic in families. That sounds so posh. I'm really looking forward to that linking so that I can tell people that I do that and I don't even know what I do anymore. Usually what happens is I make you think really deeply about your relationship with God, then I make you talk to other people about it, or I make you move and put post-its on a poster, or I make you make commitments, make a plan going forward. Try just to settle your anxieties a little bit. It's not going to be quiet like that this morning, although there is a bit of challenge in there. You will also find this morning in my sermon one and only one reference from Ice Age. There may be a prize if you spot it. Speak to me afterwards. I change it. It says read long Bible verse. So if you could all stand with me while we read God's word together, it should appear as if by magic on the wall behind you. It's 1 Corinthians 12, 12-27, and it says, one body with many parts. Just as the human body is one, though it has many parts that together form one body, so too is Christ. For by one Spirit we were all immersed and mingled into one single body. And no matter our status, whether we are Jews, non-Jews, oppressed or free, we are all privileged to drink deeply of the same Holy Spirit. In fact, the human body is not one single part, but rather many parts mingled into one. So if the foot were to say, since I am not a hand, I am not part of the body, it is forgetting that it is still a vital part of the body. And if the ear were to say, since I am not an eye, I am not really part of the body, it's forgetting that it is still an important part of the body. Think of it this way. If the whole body were just a great big eyeball, how could it hear sounds? And if the body were just an ear, how could it smell different fragrances? But God has carefully designed each member and placed it in the body to function as he desires. A diversity is required. For if the body consisted of one single part, it wouldn't be a body at all. So now we see that there are many different parts and functions, but one body. It would be wrong for the eye to say to the hand, I don't need you. And equally wrong if the head said to the foot, I don't need you. In fact, the weaker our parts, the more vital and essential they are. The body parts we think are less honourable, we treat with greater respect. And the body parts that we need to be covered in public, we treat with propriety and clothe them. But some of our body parts don't require as much attention. Instead, God has mingled the body parts together, giving greater honour to the lesser members who lacked it. He has done this intentionally, so that every member would look after the others with mutual concern, and that there would be no division in the body. In that way, whatever happens to one member happens to all. If one suffers, everyone suffers. If one is honoured, everyone rejoices. You are the body of the anointed one, and each of you is a unique and vital part of it. Thank you. That was ages. That's all about exercise. Come sit down. All will be well with you because the promises of And the Bible's really clear about what a baptism is. It talks about love. I don't know, Johnny, if these were on a slide. Yeah, let me put these on the slide for me. It's the bit that says 1 John 4:12, love and encourage one another. So God says love one another, encourage one another, serve one another, instruct one another, honour one another.
Thank you.
Hiccups in the way I perform in that role of skin. Eventually, the body starts